Hey guys, I'm about to make some really flavorful mashed potatoes with a real potato right in the microwave. And I figured I may as well make a video just in case there's any kids who really don't know how to do this. It's pretty simple. If you have a real cutting board, that's cool. Cardboard works too. You're going to want to make sure you have a microwave safe bowl. Also, mine are going to be vegetarian, but not vegan, although you can find vegan alternatives to everything I have here. Like, I know there's vegan sour cream, I know there's vegan butter or margarine. I'm gonna have two different kinds of Cabot cheese, I know there's vegan cheese, and I'm gonna throw in a little bit of milk. There's vegan milk everywhere these days. And let's see, my other ingredients. I'm going to be doing a little bit of minced garlic and olive oil, some chopped up carrots. I'm actually using baby carrots because that's even easier, but I'm still going to chop them up nice and small. I have a little knife here, salt, pepper, Italian seasoning, and yeah, I think that's it. I might throw a little ranch into them too, a little ranch dressing. So, you want to make sure that your potato has holes in it. You can either do this with, you want to be really careful if you're going to use a knife. You can either do this with a knife or a fork. I actually would recommend a metal fork if you have a metal fork. But this is what I have, so I'm just going to try to be as careful as I can with it. This is going to be the first thing that I heat up. I'm going to put it in my microwave safe bowl and do, my microwave's pretty weak, so I'll probably do 5 minutes. You might be able to do 3. I also have a bigger potato, so you have a smaller one. You know, 3 minutes might be good. So I'll say a range between like 3 to 6 minutes is probably best. So now that I've stabbed my potato in a bunch of random places, I'm also going to do my carrots now as well. If you want crunchier carrots, you don't have to cook them with your potato. But if you want them to be softer and kind of just go right into the mashed potatoes, you're going to want to cook it all together right from the start like I'm doing. I'm just gonna do like really small little pieces like that. Always be careful not to go too close to your finger. And yeah, I'm just gonna chop all these up. Also wanted to mention, make sure you wash your hands before you start doing this, or if you touch your hair or yourself or anything else, try to remember to wash your hands. In between, like, I just tied back my hair and I had to wash my hands again. Especially, I mean, even if you're just eating it yourself, but especially if you're going to be sharing it with someone. Like, I'm actually talking so quiet right now because my boyfriend's sleeping right behind me. But once this is all done, he'll probably wake up and eat with me. So I love these chopped up carrots. I'm just going to kind of all around on here. I'm gonna try to scatter them out pretty evenly. Of a low wattage, like I said. I think it's an older microwave as well, so I'm gonna do a full 5 minutes, but you probably don't need to do as long if you have a better microwave. While I wait for that, I'm gonna chop up my cheese as well. If you have a cheese grater, that's a lot easier than doing what I'm doing, but I'm gonna regular, naturally aged cheddar cheese, and then I have Cabot, seriously sharp. So I'm gonna put a little bit of both. And, yeah, by the way, just so you guys know, everything I'm using, minced garlic in extra olive oil, and Italian seasoning is, honestly, I don't even know how to pronounce that first word, I'm gonna butcher it, marjoram, rosemary, thyme, savory, sage, oregano, and basil. That's just the store brand. There's all different kinds that you can use, but when it comes to certain things, I like to have good brands, like Cabot, but when it comes to other things, store brand is totally fine. Got store brand salt and pepper, store brand Italian seasoning, all that. So I'm just gonna cut this up as small as I see fit, like pretty much as small as I can get it. I've had this cooking for about 3 minutes. My carrots are looking a little dry, so I'm actually just gonna throw a little bit of milk right in here now instead of waiting. My potato is not done cooking yet, though. You can always tell, you can always test that, and you can feel it. You can even stab into it with your fork or your knife or whatever you want. Actually, let's get in there. I will give this, like, one more minute. Maybe it doesn't need a no, it might do 2 minutes. Never hurts to cut extra holes halfway done cooking. Just make sure it cooks really evenly. So that's what that looks like now, just to show you guys. So at this point, my potatoes and carrots have been cooking for 5 minutes. Should be soft enough that I can just cut it right off and start mixing it, mix in my cheese, mix in everything. Okay, you can tell how soft that is. Gonna cut that into a bunch of chunks and then start mixing with a fork. I'm doing it with the skin right in it. I don't mind it that way, and I've heard that it has more vitamins that way as well. At this point, I've cut it up into really small pieces, so I'm gonna start mixing things in. I'm gonna have to heat it up couple more times as I'm mixing everything in. I have all my cheddar cheese here. I like a lot of cheese. Trying to go pretty evenly here. Might even add more cheese later. That's gonna melt in quite a bit. Then my Italian seasoning next. Salt. You're gonna wanna go pretty generous with the salt. Table pepper. Garlic. kind of have big piles in different spots, but I'm gonna mix it all in. It'll be alright. And it's okay. I'm gonna have to mix it a few times anyway. Put a pretty big couple chunks of butter. Those are gonna need a little bit of time to melt. I'll do 1 minute, maybe a minute and a half, and then check on it, mix it up, see where we're at. So I mixed it after 1 minute, and then I threw it in again for another 40 seconds, mixed it again. I'm gonna throw in more cheese, more salt and pepper. More Italian seasoning. Heat it up one more time. And then I think I'll be ready to throw in the sour cream. So I just stirred in that cheese to help it melt a little bit better. You don't have to go that generous on your Italian seasoning. I like a lot. Do a little bit more garlic too, but if you don't want your super garlic, you don't have to do that. Now I'm gonna do 1 minute. I mixed that up some more after it heated, and at this point I'm gonna start adding my sour cream, a little bit more garlic, more salt and pepper, maybe just a touch more Italian seasoning. Everything else seems to be there. It's really quick and easy to make. All you need is a microwave, a few ingredients, so I think it's perfect. Honestly, that's all we have in this hotel is a microwave, so I've been trying to cook more with what I've got, you know. We're gonna mix in a lot of sour cream. I will say that mine are a bit on the chunky side for mashed potatoes. I feel like they would probably be softer in a stronger microwave, but you can always cook your potato for longer in the beginning before you cut it up if you don't want it to be chunky, if you want it to be mashed, or, you know, more mushy. But I think this is going to be delicious. I just put in a bunch of sour cream, some more pepper. You guys saw me do more salt. I think this might almost be done. I'm going to heat them up for like another... maybe 40 seconds now that I have the sour cream in. So I just cooled it down a whole bunch. Oh, yeah. I'll do just a little bit more of this Italian seasoning just because I really like a lot of flavor. Salt. After warming up and mixing it again, I'm going to put in just a little bit of ranch dressing. Mix it up one more time, heat it up, and then I should be done. So, thanks for watching. Just wanted to show you guys the finished thing in better lighting. Now, just keep in mind, the main trick is just to mix and mix and mix as much as you can. If I could pick two things to add to this, I would love to have some bacon and some chopped up celery. I think it's going to be delicious as is. So, let me know if this helps you at all. I mean, I know this is like a really simple thing to make that most people probably already know how to do, but I thought it might help some kids with microwaves and, you know, people who are just starting to learn how to cook or whatever. So, yeah, thank you guys for watching. If you want to, you can give it a thumbs up, and comment, subscribe. And, yeah. Have a great rest of your day.